What are some tips for living with neurotransmitter imbalance? We're here to talk about that today. I'm Dr. Carrie Lam, this is Dr. Michael Lam. So neurotransmitter imbalance, you might have it, you might not know that you're having it, but these are just general tips that are good for anyone to even prevent neurotransmitter imbalance. The first one is to minimize intake of caffeine or even other types of stimulants. The reason why is when you drink the coffee or the tea, it really fires those neurotransmitters. And if you continue to drink and have that caffeine intake, the neurotransmitter would just go overboard and you might not have the inhibitory neurotransmitters to calm yourself down.
Yeah, of course, if you have been taking coffee for a long time, you don't want to go a cold turkey because you can kind of trigger what is called a withdrawal or rebound reactions. Huh? So you gotta go slow.
Mm-hmm. So that's just one tip, but always be careful.
Yeah, but tea, for example, also have the similar effect. Although tea's caffeine content is about half of that of coffee. So if you, what you can do is to take the caffeinated coffee, which is about 5 milligrams per serving, or the caffeinated green tea, which is even better, it has 1 or 2 milligrams versus about 45 milligrams. So these are things that you can do to kind of slowly titrate yourself down.
Right. And there are also other recommendations like eating food sources that are higher in amino acids and vitamin Bs.
Yeah, now these historically has been good to modulate people who are in a kind of a low end of the spectrum, meaning they have a tendency to be more the blues, you know, more feeling down mood. That's why the Bs are excitatory stimulants in their intrinsic property. And same thing with amino acid, they are acidic in nature. But for people with adrenal fatigue, you have to be very careful because if your body is not strong, this can actually trigger adrenal crashes.
Mm-hmm. Right. And the other idea about amino acids and vitamin Bs, those are the building blocks for the neurotransmitters. And that's why you need those compounds in order to make the neurotransmitters.
Yes, there's a lot of environmental toxins, whether it's mercury, lead, cadmium. You know, these are minerals and extraordinary compounds that does not belong in the body. And even things like herbs, glandulas, ashwagandha, green tea, we talked about earlier, maca, rhodiola, ginseng. You know, anytime you put things in the body that's excitatory, you have a tendency to cause these imbalances to happen.
Yeah, so you kind of want to also stay away from excess stimulation.
Mm-hmm.
Sensory stimulation, light stimulation, or even chronic stress that's just going around you, that's all stimulation that might overfire the neurotransmitters in your body.
Yeah, we have people that come, and some would complain, well, I walk into a room with fluorescent light, and I get a headache. Oh, I put a cell phone next to my head, and I don't touch it, I feel a headache. Well, what is really going on? Part of it is the vibration from the electromagnetic field, but part of it is that triggers the neurotransmitters to be off balance. Mm-hmm. So it's much more complex than just, you know, what people say is, you know, we don't know what's going on. We do know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And in some severe cases, when the neurotransmitters become imbalanced, as we're finding out now in high school, for example, there's an increase, alarming increase in sudden death from cardiac arrhythmias. Well, what is really going on? Yeah, we know there's a loss of cell towers around. These are all kind of circumstantial. But if you have a body that is already weak and already sensitive and is already prone to excitation, and you put that physiological construct in an environment
right,
where you exaggerate those responses, then it's the recipe for problems.
Yeah, so be careful where you're around, sensory input, basically.
Yeah, so that's why for people who, for example, if you have adrenal fatigue, we always recommend that you sleep in a perfectly dark room, 100%, so that you have increased melatonin production at night to keep the neurosensory level down. You remove all the plugs from the wall so that at least 10 feet away, even plugs to lights that may not be plugged in, they're still drawing electricity. So anytime there's vibration, this can happen. Of course, you can ground the body too. Now, these are getting to more electromagnetic field issues, but you know they are connected to neurotransmitters ultimately, because the neurotransmitters is what causes the physiological response from the head.
Right. So that's good about how you can help your environment, but how you can also help make your neurotransmitters is fish oil, omega-3s, because your neurotransmitters are all made out of fat also. So you need the good types of fat from the freshwater fish or the ocean fish. Mindfulness and yoga and breathing are always very important in calming your mind down, finding a focus for your day, and not being overexcited every day.
Very good. I'm Dr. Lam, and this is Dr. Carey here empowering you to take control of your health.